All right, and as mentioned, managed to hop into that eight man, so here we go with that. Losing a die roll, that's unfortunate. This is someone I've played against before. Someone that actually plays a lot of poppers, so should be a good match. Whatever he is bringing to the table in this case. I've seen this person play a lot of different decks, but I know he likes mono-green decks. He or she, I guess. I do not know the gender. Alright, this one is not a keeper. Not even on Chris Davis standards. There are one landers in this deck that are easy keeps, but this is an easy, easy mull. Eventually, my opponent will probably give me the option to mulligan. Either that, or he will just time out. We'll see. But I'm assuming the option to mulligan is going to happen sometime soon. It could be that my opponent is just thinking long and hard about his hand, or it could just be that I'm playing Magic Online. I don't know which. We'll find out soon. But I guess for the meantime, I'm going to pause. Alright, opponent kept 7. I am going to do the aforementioned mold of 6. Much better. A little awkward that I have to make my Sun Chaser a 2-2. But hey, I could draw an Ancient End. There are 4 on the deck. And looks like we're in for another wait on my opponent's upkeep. So, yeah, there's that. If he is actually the mono green deck, this is certainly a good hand against that deck. It could use a consistent source of color, but other than that, it's quite good. Oh, Island. Island Preordain. No. That's not cool. So, considering the Galv Bust in my hand, I'm kind of hoping he's, he's blue-red. Galv Blast is really good against that deck. Alright, so turn 1 star. He's probably going to have a super annoying Cloud of Fairies. We'll see, though. If there is a Cloud of Fairies, I'm not sure if I'm going to play around Spellstutter. I mean, I have a pretty easy way to play around it by just casting Thoughtcast. Ooh, Taxian Probe. Okay. Interesting. So that kind of makes me think it's blue-red. And now he knows I have a Blast, so he's not going to run his creature into my removal. I think he was just saying my hand, probably. Confirm that. Okay. Second Galv Blast. So I think I am just going to cast Thought Cast here. Especially considering the no second land. Wow. Okay. And Delver. Okay. Alright, well, let's see about some red mana. Maybe find something good. Doesn't look like it. Seed of the Synod, basically among the worst possible draws. Okay, Brainstorm. We'll see if he found a land yet. Oh, there one is. Wow. And I am just on the actual Netlows. So it is mono blue, it just has Gitaxian Probe in it. Oh, Frogmite. Watch out. Not quite the card I want to draw. And he's actually considering countering, which I guess means multiple counter spells and not a lot of threats. Or that he wants to tap out for something next turn, like a ninja. He thinks he's a ninja. Either of those is clearly bad news for me. My hand is already doing nothing. So for it to do less than that would be bad. Alright, time to see if I'm getting ninja'd. No, I'm not. Okay. Well, I guess I'll cast another Frogmite. And considering he knows about the Mirror Enforcer and has made it clear that he's holding up counter magic for it, I'm gonna wait. Ooh, Terrarian. Now I have to decide if I think he has another Daze. And, I mean, I'm winning the waiting game here. Yeah. Like, he's just casting a Spellstutter. So, not casting Terrarian feels like an okay decision here. Land? My goodness. Yeah. I don't think I can afford to play around Daze here. It's just a matter of the order in which I cast my spells. No, I'm still just gonna wait. Okay. Just perilous research. So bad there. Alright, in go the frogs. And I guess I'll cast yet another Frogmite. So now I can cast Mirror Enforcer, which he basically has to counter. And then that lets me resolve Terrarian, which means I can cast two Galv Blasts next turn. Yeah, that's the plan. We'll just get the mirror going, and then we'll go Terrarian. Yep, counter spell for that, so I'll play Terrarian. Spire Golem, okay. So, assumedly, that means I win. But he might have repeal for my Terrarian. Alright, so, if I untap with Terrarian, I do win. Okay. Yeah, I mean, this is pretty cut and dry. Weird game. I'm sure he's gonna type out some complaint about me drawing three Galvanic Blasts, but if it had not been a Galvanic Blast, maybe it could have been a card that I could have cast to win the game much sooner. Who knows? He's burning a little more of his time, regardless. Yeah, kind of a strange time for him to be burning time, but I definitely win the game there. There's nothing that can stop me. Alright, so. Sideboard, Pyroblasts come in. The two Grudges come in. And I'm trying to figure out if I want Leonin Squire in this matchup. I think I do, because the Atogs come out. Atogs are really bad. Rankers also just a little too vulnerable to bounce. What else do I not like in this matchup? Flayer Husk isn't that great, but you need the early drops. Could maybe take out one Flayer Husk and a Perilous Research. I think that's probably the plan. The Galv Blasts are still really good. Yeah. I mean, the one-landers that you can keep with this in this matchup are a lot less than in normal matchups. Just because of the threat of Spellstutter. And Drum is a little bit better because it gives you a consistent way to cast your Pyroblasts and your off-color spells. So, Drum is more important than Husk. Oh, but I do want Electricery also. Yeah, we'll just take out more Husks for the Electriceries. And just hope that I draw a Great Furnace. Most important card in the deck, Great Furnace.